All right, so here's a simple question. What are you doing next on the Metal Pulpit? Thanks for joining me on another Metal Pulpit. If you look behind me, you see junk that's in my yard, but you also see a lot of leaves, and that's because we're in fall, and we had a really odd week weather-wise. It was 90-some degrees this week, but now a cold front is pushing through, and our fall weather is returning. So I'm not sure how many more of these I'm going to be recording outside. I'll be going back into my indoor office to do these, but that's a question I have for you. So what are you doing? See, the Metal Pulpit is all about talking about topics from the viewpoint of a pastor that's pastoring a brick-and-mortar church building, or just building. The people in it are the church. And it's taking a viewpoint from my perspective, a pastor's perspective, and asking the simple question, what are you doing? You see, probably two blocks from my house, there's a big Methodist church, and they do a really good work. Every Tuesday they have a feeding where people from the neighborhood, those that are living on real tight budgets or just simply can't afford their next meal, can come and get some help, you know, by having a Tuesday night meal provided to them. And so I've been living in this area for 13 years, and I saw that many years ago, and I wrote a blog about it. And I said, so these people that are getting their needs met, obviously on a very fixed budget, very fixed income, and there's nothing wrong with that. But the question I have is, what are they doing to make a difference? What are they doing to give back? Because they're being blessed, and because we're blessed, we're supposed to be a blessing to others as well. Well, it was a question that I posed in the form of a blog, and it was met with quite a bit of resistance, but also a lot of people saying amen to it. But I look at it from the viewpoint of a pastor, and I say, so what are you doing? Because quite honestly, if all we're doing is podcasts and blogs and crafty Facebook updates and sharing some Toby Mac memes, those drive me nuts. Are you really that effective at that point? I mean, yeah, I realize it's our way of getting a message out, but what are you doing to serve? And that's the question I want to hang out on, because quite honestly, me doing a blog or a podcast or anything about this topic, it's really not serving. It's getting us thinking a little bit, and any podcast, blog that we listen to or read, it gets us thinking, but I'm not serving you. I'm not serving you anything right now except maybe a little bit of knowledge. You see, we've done a few things at the church that raised some eyebrows. We had a young lady years ago who ended up with breast cancer. And shortly after that, she found out how evasive a surgery she's going to need. A double mastectomy, in fact. And she just bought a car. She had a good job. She was in her 20s. And she came to me and said, I don't know what to do. Well, I went to our board and I said, I think we know what we need to do. So we sent a letter out to the church people, and they replied favorably. We ended up taking over her car payments for a year so that she could have the surgery and recover. And I'm glad to say she's doing much better since left the church. But, you know, these things happen. But we did the right thing. And then we had a savings for a city outreach we were going to do. We were going to put $1,000 into this gas program that we were going to do. And it was about ready to launch. And then we had a mom with raising three or four girls tell us that her farmhouse needs a roof desperately. And it did. The plaster was falling from the inside. And so we literally, the local government wouldn't help out. And so we said, this is a no-brainer. We have to put this money into her roof and redo her roof. So as a church family, we did that. We did another roof for a single lady, owned a straight ranch style home and was quoted thousands for a new roof, and she needed one. I said, you know what, you buy the supplies, we'll supply the manpower, we'll get it done. And in one weekend, she had a new roof. You see, we're all gifted with something. We all have a way a thing to offer, but when we rely on the pastor or a church to provide the venue for you to serve, well, then we start sitting back and saying, well, that's not really what I want to do. I'm not really into sports. I don't agree with that guest speaker he's bringing in. I don't, those people that came to the outreach we did, they're really not needy. I know them, and they come around. We come up with all the excuses in the world. So the question falls back on you or them. What are you doing to make a difference? because we have to make a difference. The whole Jesus washing the feet, the disciples thing, I don't want anybody washing my feet. They're nasty. I don't like pedicures. And so nobody should be subjected to that. That wasn't the main point of Jesus washing feet, for us to go around and go up to people and say, can I wash your feet? No, you'd probably get punched in the mouth. So what is that all about? It's about serving. It's about helping people out. It's about saying, where can I help you? I'm going through a difficult time right now with my mom. Her health is slipping. She's elderly. And quite honestly, I don't get down to Milwaukee as much as I can because I live 2 hours north. And things get tight and stuff, and people say, praying for you. I get that, and I appreciate it. When somebody comes up to you and says, I can't get out anywhere because of kids. I can't afford this. Something's coming due. And we say, I'm praying for you. That doesn't really help. It does if you get, you know what I mean. It helps that you're praying, but serve. Get out and do something. I'll even say, go far as this. If your life is in turmoil, or you're depressed, or some things that you're just kind of in a funk, serve. Go out and help people and see how much good that does for you and your soul. And I think that's because Jesus hardwired us, God hardwired us to serve people. His son did it in his earthly ministry, and we're called to do the same. Thanks for listening. Have a great day.